Good evening, guys. This side, Rahul Magan here as a Group Chief Executive Officer, Treasury Consulting, and also a venture capitalist. Standing today, I'm going to be shooting a video, which I think is a little turning point as far as the non-performing assets in India is concerned. Yesterday, which is 21st, we got a news. And what is that news? That banks set sights on guarantees. Before I deliberate further, let me give you a little bit of background about this. So there is an international document called ISTA. ISTA stands for International Swaps and Derivative Association. It's a universal document which is between you and the buyer. Having said that, ISTA is the father. There are six brothers and sisters we do have, and all brothers and sisters are listed on our fixed income platform www.fixedincome.global. If you need any help, we can share the link, no problem. These six documents or six brothers and sisters are universal in nature. Either it is lending, it is any kind of foreign exchange contract, it is any kind of revocation, it is any kind of collateral, these all come into the picture, and they all are a sort of binding agreements. So binding agreement means that if you signed it, you signed it. That is a binding agreement. It depends upon the scope whether there is some leeway here or there or not. And ISTA is being managed by an international body, which is ISTA. ISTA Master Service Agreement 2005 as of now. Due to the LIBOR transitioning, there is a hell lot of changes which is happening in ISTA, which is RFR, risk-free rates. Currently, there are 9 candidates of risk-free rate, and the leading is definitely SOFR. But the credit has to go to coronavirus, that the LIBOR transitioning, which was set for roughly September 21, is more or less postponed, officially or non-officially, because even regulators understand that if at that point of time, they will push the banks to go ahead for LIBOR transitioning, it is like pushing the weakest animal to have the heaviest weight. So they also understand, according to me, LIBOR transitioning is more or less history, but at the same point of time, the international regulators is not putting any force on the banks not to trade SOFR, Saron, Cora, and all these products. So if you go to Bloomberg and the Reuters terminal, you can see that banks are taking up these positions. Some are taking, some are not taking. So this is one thing. So whenever a corporate take any foreign currency position, so example, let me give an example of a company called Ram Lal & Company. Ram Lal & Company is taking a foreign exchange position from JP Morgan Chase US. Ram Lal & Company needs to sign ISTA. And that ISTA is a binding agreement. And by the way, ISTA also includes the default clause, the tax clause, and the M&A clause. Everything includes. I'm sure that 99% of the people, those watching this video, they even not heard about ISTA, and forget reading ISTA, and forget even chasing ISTA as an institute, that what all they up to. By the way, Treasury Consulting is continuously not only researching about ISTA, but also helping ISTA as an organization, that what all best you can do in the form of commenting in the public domain. This is one way of funding. Another way of funding is definitely the personal guarantee, which means that Ram Lal & Company takes funding from JP Morgan India. Whenever any company take a position from from a foreign bank, either this foreign bank is in India, example JP Morgan, Standard Chartered, Barclays, UBS, your BNP Paribas, HSBC and all, they push the companies, basically the counterparties, to sign up that agreement. And I think this is a right practice. Although at various fronts, Treasury Consulting holding deep indemnification issue with these so-called banks, but I think one of the good things these banks always do is to sign a requisite documentation, which is counterparty agreements, which I think it's okay, which is a good practice. One way, if Ram Lal & Company take up funding from Indian banks, say SBI, I'm just giving an example. If In practical life, there is any company called Ram Lal and Company who have taken from our SBI. This is a pure coincidence. So if Ram Lal and Company taken from SBI, then forget ISDA. They are having multiple options like collateral and all, because Indian banks still governing like 1857. And one of the ways is the personal guarantee. Personal guarantee means when the promoter, basically the leading promoter. So assuming Ram Lal and Company having two promoters, Ram Lal and Shyam Lal. Ram Lal holding 50% stake, while Shyam Lal, who is the brother of Ram Lal, holding 10%. Either together or Ram Lal alone can give a personal guarantee that this 1000 crore which I am taking from SBI as a working capital loan would be refunded, of course, along with the interest as per the agreement. And if not, then I, Ram Lal, who is the promoter, is responsible for not paying it, and I am pledging my this asset having valuation this as at that day. This is personal guarantee. And the unfortunate part of the life is that even today, although this is an indemnification issue between Treasury Consulting Group and ISDA, which is that the personal guarantee do not have a unified format, which means there is one format which is applied across the globe on personal guarantee. The same is the case in India. So if 10 promoters are giving personal guarantee, they are using different formats, which creates interpretation issue. So even for bank, suppose Ram Lal and Company defaults on 1000 crore not paid, and SBI come and said, hey, now I'm going to be taking your collateral in my control, because this is personal guarantee. Personal guarantee always have indemnification issues, but ISDA never, because it's a standard binding agreement across the globe. And one of the important objectives of any regulator is to have a unified format of the personal guarantee. This will resolve years and years of courts, years and years of lawyers and all bodies to interpret that. But who cares? According to an information on 21st September 2020 in the media, state-run banks are set to invoke the personal guarantee given by as many as 300 promoters for the corporate loans following instructions from Finance Ministry. Two people with the direct knowledge of the development said. It means that about 300 promoters are subject to get notified from the banks regarding the personal guarantee they issued. What is the quantum of that 300? Basically, how much funding this 300 corporates taken? Somehow this information is not there. But there is another set of information on the different page pertaining to this, which is a personal guarantee obligation, the guarantor to pay back a business loan if the corporate borrower defaults. In such cases, promoters typically provide personal asset as collateral. According to the industry estimate, promoters have provided personal guarantee to the state-run dues worth 1.85 trillion. Oops. 1.85 trillion is around 1,85,000 crores. 1,85,000 crore, which is definitely not a small amount. It means that I really do not know out of this 1,85,000 crore how much is the NPA, because that data is definitely not available. And if data is not available, we cannot speak. But I'm sure a handsome amount of out of 1.85 lakh crore is definitely personal guarantee. And guys, one important thing in the personal guarantee is also the present value, which I am pushing in the system, but the sleeping and the blind regulators not listening to it, which is, if I am Ram Lal, who is giving a personal guarantee to the tune of 1000 crores to SBI, at a given point of time, this personal guarantee is subject to have a present value. But if my company performance deteriorates on a daily basis and financial matrices continue to deteriorate, then the day is not far when this personal guarantee is nothing but a piece of paper. And then this piece of paper in the international market is good for nothing. It's nothing. Now the question is, and that is a more important question, banks may consider putting in place a mechanism for monitoring the cases which may require initiation of the individual insolvency processes before NCLT against personal guarantee and so on and so forth, all theory. Promoters have provided personal guarantee to the state-run bank to the tune of 1.85 lakh crore. And guys, see this, some data has been provided. Source is the company filing. In Videocon, this is to the tune of 90,000 total debt of the company. Videocon total debt is around 90,000 crores. DHFL is around 85,000 crores. Bhushan Steel around 48,000 crore. Arvind Dham, which is MTech Auto, is around 12,000 crores. And Jet Airways is around 11,000 crores. The moral of the story is pretty clear. The personal guarantee always hold two obligations from the bank side. Number one, the continuous present value of that. And considering the knowledge level of Indian public sector banks, we know that, forget the present value, they even do not know the fair value. Second important thing, do we have an alternate market in India wherein these personal guarantee can be traded? Example, what is the basic premise of insolvency and bankruptcy code? The basic premise of insolvency and bankruptcy code is there is a company who is now insolvent, somebody outside party or inside party, offshore or inland party, came in public domain and say, hey, I buy this. Go ahead. They will say, the court will say, the total outstanding debt is 1,000 crore. What bid you put? The party say 200 crores. It means 80% haircut straight. And who is paying the haircut? Taxpayers. But the question is, this is what the basic intent of insolvency and bankruptcy court. When I first gave somewhere 2 to 3 years ago a lecture for Institute of Company Secretary of India at Bhubaneswar, India, I raised this point. And I said that one of the basic premises of insolvency and bankruptcy code, or one should be one mandated premises for insolvency and bankruptcy IBC code, should be to create an alternate mechanism in India whereby these personal guarantee can be traded. Example, SBI hold a personal guarantee of Ramlal and company. I am Ramlal and I clearly raise my hand, I am not paying 1,000 crore. Whatever you wanted to do. SBI can sell this personal guarantee to a party who is known as Sachin Kochar. Sachin Kochar say, okay, you give this personal guarantee to me, I will handle it, I'll pay you money. But do we have that market? By the way, before to conclude this video, in an ideal scenario, personal guarantee should be backed up by SBLC. Standby letter of credit. And I'm 200% sure that 99% of the people who are watching this video even do not know how to link a personal guarantee with SBLC. I'm very happy nowadays because of multiple reasons. And one of the reasons is that the business newspapers have finally decided that in another 2 to 3 years, they will dilute the knowledge of all nationals. Because if I would be the author of this article, I would have mentioned that personal guarantee should be backed up by SBLC. And I once again close this video with a beautiful line. In 2007, business newspaper was all about getting knowledge, and now it is all about losing knowledge. But I feel regret that millions and millions of young millennials or young guns, those who are closer to my heart, they really do not know what they are reading and what output they can expect from that. This is Rahul Bagan from Treasury Consulting. You know our WhatsApp, 9818485155. Treasury Consulting know the difference between practical and theory knowledge. Have a good time, guys. Talk soon.